Welcome to another Group Iron Man episode. This one will be all about the next preparations, and to start off, I have two clue scrolls completed here from Slayer. The medium clue, we are looking for Ranger boots, which is very rare of course, but that is the ideal item. And from the hard clue scrolls, we are looking for God Dehyde bodies. So let's start with the medium one and see what we get. And we get... that is not Ranger boots, is what I can say. And for the hard one, we get... a Saradom in page 1, which is not very useful, but there is going to be plenty more clue scrolls in this video, hopefully. Oh yes, that is a hefty diagonal task that's going to be all done on the Kings. Let's hope we get a Berserker Ring, which is the last one for the team, which is going to be mine, coincidentally, or an Archer's Ring, which actually would be maybe even better because of Nex. Well, that kind of creeped up on me, 74 Slayer, and I've been here for like 50 kills so far, no rings, but I did get a hard clue, so we will open all of them, as many as I get from the task at the end. Well, that is the task finished. I got no rings, but I did get a Dragon Axe, which means I have 4 Dragon Axes in my bank, and we actually already have one each, so we have way too many of them. But I did get 3 hard clue scrolls, so let's see if we can get any God Dehyde bodies. First one is terrible, second one is somehow even worse, and the last one is a collection log item, but that is very bad hard clues, unfortunately. It has been quite a while since something happened, but I just got a Commander Celiana task, and I think I might actually with this gear be able to solo a couple of kills, so I'm going to set this to like maybe 9. That should be enough. If I get 3 keys, I should at least be able to do 3 kill trips. Should be able to do more than that, but I think 9 is good enough. That is the task done, and I had to do it in 2 trips, and the second trip was only the last 2 kills. I did 7 kills and then 2 kills, and I am probably just going to teleport out here. Even though I have supplies, it is not really worth it to do this solo compared to in a group. Oh my god, I got 3 Kriara as a task, or well, I picked 3, but I have no points, and doing this is going to be quite hard. It is actually the last God Wars boss I haven't done on this account, and I am going to get 2 hunter levels for Black Chins and try to solo it. And this is going to be 73 hunter. I think I am going to catch like maybe 150 Black Chins or something like that. I think that should be enough for 3 kills. Also, by the way, I am going to get the last piece of the Frozen Key if I do manage to kill Kriara. So that is going to be pretty nice to have the Frozen Key completed as well. Only encountered 1 PKer and I did not die, and that should be 201, so I went for a bit more than 150. Hopefully I will be able to do all the 3 kills in one trip, but Armadill is a very hard God Wars dungeon boss compared to the other ones, especially to solo, so it might be hard to do that. Well, it was a very long time since I did Armadill, and I kind of oversighted that I can't only kill it with Shinchompas. I should have brought bolts as well. I did have the crossbow for the Mithril Grapple to get over here, but I didn't even think about that the minion of course is going to die when doing this, because you want to Chinchompa the minion that is standing beside Kriara like I'm doing now, and that way, well, Kriara has very high defense, but if you hit the minion with the Chinchompa, it is going to counter the defense of the minion. You do damage to that and the splat damage will go over to Kriara counting the minion's defense. So as you can see, I am shredding Kriara this way even though it has very high defense, and as long as you click on Kriara between each hit on the minion, it is not going to do anything except just range you, so you won't take that much damage. But look at this, I kind of thought I could Chinchompa the minion, but that was not the case. Try the blowpipe, but then I don't have the crystal shield on, so that was kind of a disaster. But yeah, even forgetting the bolts, I did manage to get 2 kills, so I have to go back for the last one. But in that trip we got the last key piece, so let's now assemble them and get the Frozen Key. That kind of looks like the RS3 version, but a bit more chunky, I guess. And it doesn't seem to have any charges, so that's interesting. It does in the RS3 version for Nex, but seems like it's infinite here. Well, I did have enough Chinchompas at least, but I am going to leave right now with the task completed. That was not a nice task to do. It took a very long time, but at least I unlocked Black Chinchompas as an opportunity. Maybe we will use it when we group it in the future. Still hunting for the Dagonoth King task, which I haven't got in a long while now, but that is 75 Slayer, which is a pretty nice milestone. Also, as you can see, I unlock Gargoyles, and if I do get a Gargoyle task, I will try to get the Brittle Key. I'm not really sure how it works exactly. I think it's like after 100 Gargoyle kills, you get it guaranteed. I'm not really sure, but when I do get the key, I am going to try some of the Grotesque Guardians. It has been quite a lot of tasks, and I still do not have a Dagonoth task. But after this one, I will be on task 99, and that is also 89 range, the main reason why I'm recording. But after this, I can do a corner task, and it's going to be task number 100, and I should get a bunch of points. And with those, I will try really hard to get a Dagonoth task. If I do not get one, I am most likely just going to go there with a crystal helmet or something and do it without a Slayer task, because I really want that Archer's Ring. Now, before we complete task number 100, I have a couple of more hard clue scrolls that I collected, three more, so let's pray for that Dehyde bodies. Let's see what we can get. First one is a Samurak page, not really what we want, but it is a collection log. Second one is terrible. These are so bad, all the hard clues in this video so far. Please, last one. Ooh, Master Scrollbook, that is not that bad. I guess it is a unique, but no God Dehyde bodies yet. About to be done with the task pretty soon and get all those points, but look at this, 4 brimstone keys, and I think I have 6 in my bank as well. I haven't really bothered opening them, but I can just do a rapid, quick succession of opening them after this. Oh, that is lovely to see. Almost 500 points from having like no points at all. So let's hopefully get spooned on a Dagonoth task so I don't have to waste all the points. Well, it is not a Dagonoth task, but I said I'm going to do a Gargoyle task if I get it. And how the Brittle Key that unlocks the boss works is it's a 1 in 150 drop rate from the normal Gargoyles. So I should get one of the keys in this kill count, but you never know. Either all of them will be on the normal ones if I don't get the key, or I might do a couple of bosses to try it out. Before that though, let's do this real quick. I'm just going to spam open, and the items I would be looking for is just the Dark Mystic items, I guess, because they are collection log items and pretty cool to get. Oh, of course, the Raynar seeds are very nice as well. I can't really complain about that. And the two last keys, steel bars, I actually want to make into cannonballs most likely. If I get the granite dust also from the Grotesque Guardians, you can actually upgrade the cannonballs and get even more value out of them. And that is some nice ranged experience, which I gladly would like to have for next. Oh, that is nice. I only took half the task pretty much to get the Brittle Key. So we have 91 kills left to do. I am not going to postpone the DK's grind for the Archer's Ring that much, but I want to do a couple of kills at least. That is a lot of combat tasks, and I did very poorly on that one. Like, what was the kill time? 252. Yeah, I can definitely improve on that. Super combat potions. Yeah, look at these drops, man. This is actually the first or basically the only way for us to get super combat potions on the group Iron Man right now, because it is a very high herb lore level requirement. It's like 90, so it's nice to get some. I don't think it's really worth for me to be here for very long, so I'm just going to be done at 10kz. It was fun to try it. In the future, I am definitely going to do more kills, but this is the loot for 10 kills. It's not terrible, but I want to get done with the task as fast as possible. I actually got 76 Slayer by finishing on the normal ones, but Barrow's Brothers as a task. If I pick 6 of them, that should be 1 round, and I just want to get Dagonoths at this point, so I will do 1 run of Barrow's. Maybe we will get lucky and get some Carol's items. The one and only Barrow's chest for this video, let's see what we get. And oh my god, wait, I actually think that's the last piece. That is actually full Guthans. I am... dude, what? That is so nice! I have no more points now. This is the last chance I have to get a Dagonoth task. If I don't get it, I am just going to go to DK's without a Slayer helmet, which is fine to get the Archer's Ring. But let's see if we can get one. And we do not get one. We get a terrible task as well. But yeah, let's go to DK's off task. Well, that is unfortunate. That is very early into the trip. Unfortunately, we don't really need the Seer's Ring for anything, but I guess it's nice to get something at least. Again, not really the item I want, but that is actually the second mod battle staff we have for the team, and I got both of them. I guess there is the Lunar Spellbook that has some uses for that. Oh my god, what is this? A seer collar? I'm not sure really if that's useful for anything. Maybe there is some dye or something you need it for, but would be nice to get some rings instead of these weird drops. And that is the second ring drop, Warrior's Ring, not what we want to see. I think the team has like 8 or 9 of them right now. There it is, the Berserker Ring, which is the 5th one for the team, being my Berserker Ring, so I am going to imbue this later in the video. Very nice to see, done with that, only need the Archer's Ring now for the team. So I'm at like 300 DKs killed, you can see here on the side. I have 89 Prime, 91 Rex and 94 Supreme. Supreme being the one that can drop the Archer's Ring, and it is a 1 in 128. So technically I am not unlucky on the Archer's Ring just yet. Of course I have overall like 250 Supreme kills or something, so I should have one by now. But we are going to take a break here. I will go back to it in the video and try to get that Archer's Ring, because I really want it for next. But we're going to take a break here to help the team get the last shard to the Frozen Key. I already have it, as you guys saw, but most of the team doesn't have the Kriara one, so we're going as a team to get that for everyone. And by the way, look at this, 7 Dragon Axes. But the team is currently getting Ecumenical Keys, so I am going to go to Nightmare Zone, get some points, and try to imbue the Berserker Ring as well. Well, I barely had any time to get any points, but I do want to show off how much points I actually get now compared to before. So when I had way less quests completed, I got like 2k points from one kill. And look at this now, 58 to 83,000. I just got like 30,000 points from one single NPC kill. So getting like 800k, or maybe it's even 1.2 million for the Berserker Ring, I'm not sure exactly, is not going to be very hard. You can get like 2 million points an hour. Oh, and this is the big one. That was like, what, 60,000 points from the Inadequacy? That is why the Dream Mentor quest is very nice to have for the Nightmare Zone. So the strategy we're doing for Armadale is basically everyone in a corner. We just protect the range and everyone shoots the boss. And this way it is going to just be stuck in the middle, only doing ranged hits. So as you can see now, we all attack it. It just sits there in the middle. And the minion you can see over here, the Flight Kilisa, is the melee minion. It is basically just going back and forth to each person, basically doing nothing. Of course, we still take some damage from the minions. Like the Major can hit me for pretty high amounts of damage, but otherwise it is a very AFK and chill, as you can see. So we finished all the key pieces for the team, but we didn't really get any rare drops. Of course, we only did like 10 kills or something, so can't expect anything. But it's only 650 to imbue the ring, so now it is the imbued Berserker Ring. And if I do manage to get the Archer's Ring, which I am going back to DKs now and praying for it, then I will have to get another 650k points, which is like 20 minutes, so definitely not bad. God, are you kidding me?
Yeah, congratulations, man.
No, that's not the ring I want, dude. Another circle.
Oh, shit.
Not like this, dude. Give me the Archer's Ring already. I'm killing Supreme now, so hopefully I get it. Another Seer's Ring. I have so many rings that is not the Archer's Ring at this point. And that is a third Berserker Ring for me, which we now have, I think that is 7 Berserker Rings, which we definitely do not need. But I guess if we're going to PK on Group Iron, then we have that. Oh my god, I actually got it. There is no way. That was my last trip. I was going to leave after this. Oh my god, that is such a relief. I'm going to show you guys all the loot here, how many kills I did. I did 170 Supreme, 161 Prime, and 163 Rex. And look at all that Rex loot. 3 Berserker Rings, 4 Dragon Axes. Actually, let me go to the bank real quick. I am going to show you guys how many Dragon Axes I have, how many like rings overall I have. Oh my god. I think I did like 10 trips to DKs. Look at this. And also I have basically 74 prayer banked here for when we do get the rigor. Look at all of these rings. The Warrior's Rings are way too many. We have way too many. I think we have overall 10 or something. The Dragon Axes, we already have way too many. I guess we have like 14 now. And Berserker Rings as well. But that is the first Archer's Ring for the team. So let's go and imbue it. Finally, we have the imbued Archer's Ring. That is so nice to see. It has 8 ranged attack bonus and 8 ranged defense. The 8 ranged attack bonus being very nice for Nex, because it is probably going to have very high defense, so it is super good to have that. And I am still unsure if I'm going with the crossbow or the crystal armor with a bow for Adinan, but regardless, this is going to be an essential ring to have. Now, to end the video, I do have one last hard clue scroll that I got from the Dagonoth Kings. Let's see if we can get a god dehyde body for the team. I am going to use the crystal armor at Nex, but can we help out the team? And that's a lot of uniques. Enchanted top and pith helmet in the same one, but not a god dehyde body. But with that, I am going to end the video here. Tomorrow we are going to do Nex on release as a team, hopefully get a couple of kills, and I will make a video on it. Likewise, the whole team probably will, so you will get a lot of content in the next day. So thank you guys for watching, hope you liked it. Remember to leave a like if you did, subscribe for future content, and click any other videos on the screen right now if you want to see content right away. Have a good one, guys. Take care.